Good morning. In today's class, we'll be continuing to discuss about fins. In the last class, we started discussing fins. Let me recap about fins and then we can proceed with the remaining topics. A fin is an extended surface which is used for enhancing the heat transfer where we have an area constraint so that the convective coefficient and the temperature difference are predominant compared to that of the area. That is the application of fin. So in case of fins, we have three types of fin. One is to be the short fin, end insulated, a short fin, end not insulated, and infinitely long fin. So in the last class, we derived the equation of heat transfer and temperature difference, temperature distribution for an infinitely long fin. In this class, we will be discussing about an end fin, a short fin, end insulated, and a short fin, end not insulated. End insulated in the sense there won't be any heat transfer through that end. So the boundary conditions for this fin would be at x equal to 0, theta would be equal to theta naught. That is, T minus TA would be T naught minus TA. The second boundary condition would be at x equal to L, as I said earlier, there won't be any heat transfer through that phase, right? Once we apply this boundary condition in the generalized equation, theta on applying these boundary conditions in this equation, we get an equation of theta, the temperature difference to be theta naught . This would be the temperature difference, the temperature distribution. The same way Q fin would be where L is the length of the fin M to be the same way. If we consider a short fin, end not insulated, in this case, the boundary condition would be at x equal to 0, the same way theta would be equal to theta naught, that is T minus TA would be T naught minus TA. The second would be at x equal to L, here the end phase is not inserted, so that at the end phase we have a conduction and also convection, right? So that, let us suppose this to be the end phase, from here to here it would be conduction and from here to here it would be convection. So that if we consider the n cross section, here we have conduction and convection. So the heat conducted to this plane would be equal to the heat convected from this plane. So that here the equation would be Q conduction would be equal to Q convection. So that minus Ka dT by dx at x equal to L would be equal to HA T minus TA. So here the area would be same. So DT by DX at x equal to L would be H by K T minus TA. So these are the two boundary conditions for this short fin, end not insulated, so that once we again apply these two boundary conditions, sorry, in this generalized equation, so we get theta to be equal to, this is the temperature distribution equation, Q fin would be the same way. So this would be the equation for Q fin. So this is about the types of fin. So now we will be solving certain problems for each type of fins, and we will be concluding the first unit, right? Let me read out the problem. A very long copper rod of thermal conductivity 377 watt per meter Kelvin of 1 centimeter dia is exposed to an environment at 22 degrees centigrade. The base temperature of the rod is maintained at 150 degrees centigrade. The heat transfer coefficient between the rod and the surrounding air is 11 watt per meter square Kelvin. Estimate the heat transfer rate from the rod to the surrounding and fin efficiency. So here they have mentioned it to be a very long fin. So it would be coming under the condition of infinitely long fin. So the condition is, infinitely long fin. So for this infinitely long fin, they are given K of the fin to be 377 watt per meter Kelvin and dia to be 1 centimeter, then T A to be 22 degree centigrade and T naught to be 150 degree centigrade. Then they are given H of the surrounding to be 11 watt per meter square Kelvin. They are asking us to find Q, then effectiveness of fin. This is what they are asking. So in order to find out Q, we know the equation of Q to be, for infinitely long fin it would be So we are here to find out the perimeter and area. Here it is a copper rod of dia 1 centimeter. We are supposed to find out the area of the cross section of the fin and also the perimeter of the cross section of the fin. So it is a circular part, so that the area would be pi by 4 d square. We get it to be the same way, by the same way we get perimeter to be 2 pi r, which would be, so on substituting these values in this equation, we get Q fin to be 2 pi r. Now they asked us about the effectiveness of fin. As I have stated earlier, the fin effectiveness would be Q fin by Q without fin. So we have found out Q fin. Q without fin would be the normal convection through that area on which the fin is protruded. So it would be H A T naught minus T A. Eleven. on finding out this value and substituting this in this equation, we get phi effectiveness. Generally, the value of phi effectiveness would be greater than 1. Generally, it would be greater than 1. Now, let's move on to a second problem. Let me read out the problem. A turbine blade 6 cm long, having cross-sectional area of 4.65 cm square and perimeter 12 cm, is made of stainless steel, K to be 23.3 watt per meter Kelvin. The temperature at the root is 500 degree centigrade. The blade is exposed to a hot gas at 870 degree centigrade. The heat transfer coefficient between the blade surface and the gas is 442 watt per meter Kelvin. Determine the temperature distribution and the rate of heat flow at the root of the blade, the fin efficiency, fin effectiveness. Assume the tip of the blade to be insulated. So, the type of fin is given to be a short fin, end insulator. So, length would be 6 cm. Then they are given A to be 1, perimeter to be 12 cm. And then they are given K as 23.3 watt per meter Kelvin, then T naught to be 500 degree centigrade and TA to be 870 degree centigrade, and they are given the value of H to be 442 watt per meter Kelvin. They are asking us to find the Q, theta, the temperature distribution, and then fin efficiency, then effectiveness of fin. So, first let us find out the temperature distribution. So, for a short fin end insulator, the temperature distribution would be so this is the temperature distribution equation. You can find out the value of m to be root of hp by ka. On substituting the value, we get the value of m as 6.696. Once we substitute this in this, we get an equation to be so this will be the temperature distribution. So now let's move over to the heat transfer through fin. So for this, the heat transfer would be So we get the value of Q to be 280.3 watts. So this, the negative sign indicates the heat is not transferred from the system to the surrounding, it is being transferred from the surrounding to the system. So in order to find out the fin efficiency, the formula would be tan H ML by ML. It would be less than 1. The same way fin effectiveness would be Q fin by Q without fin. You can solve it. Let's move on to the next problem. A cylinder 1 meter long and 5 centimeter dia is placed in an atmosphere at 45 degree centigrade. It is provided with 10 longitudinal straight fins of material having K to be 120 watt per meter Kelvin and height of 0.76 mm thick fin is 1.27 centimeter from the cylinder surface. The heat transfer coefficient between the cylinder and the atmosphere is 17 watt per meter square Kelvin. To calculate the rate of heat transfer and temperature at the end of fins, if the surface temperature of the cylinder is 150 degree centigrade. So the condition of the fin is a short fin in not insulated. So for this, let me explain the problem. So they are giving a cylinder of 1 meter long and it is of 5 centimeter dia. They are stating that it has 10 longitudinal fins. They are stating it has 10 longitudinal fins. The thickness of the each individual fin is given to be 0.76 mm and the height is given to be 1.27 centimeter. So for this, they are asking us the heat transfer from the system to the surrounding. That's what they are asking. So let's start solving this problem. Here, since it is a cylinder with 10 fins, we have been given that all the circumferential area of the cylinder won't be covered by fins. The uncovered area will be left out over the circumferential region of the fin or circumferential region of the cylinder, so that for those areas we have to assume it to be the heat transfer through normal convection, and the area which is covered with fins we have to find out the heat transfer through fin. First let us find out the heat transfer through fin. In order to do so, let's write the given data. The dimension of cylinder is given to be 1 meter long and 5 centimeter, and TA is given to be 45 degree centigrade and number of fins to be 10. The conductivity of material is 120 watt per meter Kelvin and they are given height of the fin 1.27 centimeter and they are given the thickness or width of the fin to be 0.76 mm. And they are given this height, right? They are given the heat transfer coefficient to be 17 watt per meter square Kelvin. The same way, the temperature of surface temperature of cylinder to be 150 degree centigrade. They are asking us to find Q Q overall. And the next thing is temperature at end of the field. So this thing can be found out from the temperature distribution. First, let us focus on this. So the heat transfer through fin, right? Since it is a short fin, and not insulated, let's find out the perimeter. Perimeter would be twice of the length and the thickness, right? So it would be 1 meter. So approximately the perimeter would be equal to 2 meters. The same way for area, it would be 0.76 10 power minus 3 into 1, which would be 0.76 10 power minus 3 meter square. So now let us find out the value of m. This would be 19.33. So now let us go for the heat transfer through fin. Since it is a short fin and not insulated, from the derivation which we have found out earlier, this would be 0.76. So on substituting the known values in this equation, we get Q fin to be 45.65 kilowatt per fin. So now in order to find out the heat transfer, so we have to get the heat transfer through the base which is not covered through fin, the region of base which is not covered through fin, and of fin, right? So this would be HA T naught minus TA area uncovered plus 10 into Q individual fin, right? So here it has been given that H area would be for cylinder, the circumferential area would be pi into d, and we have to reduce the area which is being covered through fin. So those things, those areas would be 10 into, for a individual fin, the area would be 1 into 0.76 in 10 power minus 3 into T naught minus TA plus 10 into Q fin 1 for an individual fin. So on substituting these values, so we get Q overall to be 723.82 watts. So now let us go on temperature distribution. The temperature distribution equation for a short fin and not insulated would be on substituting the known values with this equation, we get t to be 146.74 degrees centigrade. So now we have solved a problem for all the three types of fin. So I hope it would be clear to you. In the next class, we will be starting the second unit, the convection. Thank you.